Hi, this is Devin from Gempler's Product Support. Today we're going to go through how to calibrate your sprayer. Calibrating your sprayer is necessary to ensure accurate application rates and provide effective pest control. Spraying the proper amount and getting the most even disbursement is critical to your success. You need to know how much chemical you're applying for four important reasons. If you're applying a different amount other than what is directed on the label, you could be violating the law and could be fined, risking the chance of damaging desirable plants in the area, wasting money on pesticide that is sprayed unnecessarily, or ineffectively controlling your target pest. Be sure to check the instruction manual for your sprayer. The manufacturer might have a specific method they would like you to use. There are many different methods for calibrating your sprayer. Today we're just going to use one. Here are the tools you will need to calibrate your sprayer: a sprayer rig, stopwatch, measuring tape, measuring container graduated in ounces, or a digital sprayer calibrator, flags or stakes for marking, pocket calculator, pen and paper for recording your data. Before we begin, it's important to make sure you're wearing the proper personal protective equipment. Goggles, gloves, closed-toe shoes, and long sleeves are some common articles of PPE that might be required. Always start with a clean sprayer. Fill your sprayer about half full with clean water. The first thing to do is measure the spacing between the nozzles in inches. In the field, measure out a test course that corresponds to the distance between your nozzles. Our nozzles were spaced 20 inches apart, so our test course is going to be 204 feet. With the course set up, taking a running start, run the course from start to finish at the speed that you would be applying your chemicals. Measure the time in seconds. Once you're done running the course, park your rig and set the brakes. If appropriate for your spray rig, keep the engine running at the same RPM as you used to run the course. Set your sprayer pump pressure correctly for the sprayer tip type that you have and the desired gallons per minute of chemical that you'd like to apply. This information can be found on the instruction manual for your sprayer as well as in the pesticide labeling. Using your plastic container marked in ounces, collect water from each tip for the same amount of time it took you to drive the test course. Check to see that the flow rate from each nozzle is approximately the same. Replace or clean any nozzle whose output differs by more than 5% from the average for all the nozzles. Check flow rates again if any nozzles needed to be replaced. In this example, the average nozzle output is 13.4 ounces. 5% of 13.4 ounces is 0.67 ounces. Any nozzle whose output differs from 13.4 ounces by more than 0.67 ounces should be cleaned and replaced. That is, any nozzle whose output is greater than 14.07 or less than 12.73. In this example, all were within an acceptable range. Once all of your spray tips are outputting within 5% of each other, your average spray tip output for your course time is used to calculate your gallons per acre. So for our example, our gallons per acre is 13.4. For minor adjustments in output, adjust the sprayer pressure to achieve the gallons per acre required by the pesticide labeling. For major adjustments, change the travel speed or change the spray tip size. If you change your spray tips or make any other adjustments, be sure to recheck your flow rates and recalibrate your rig. For help with any questions on sprayer calibration, on pesticide labeling, or finding the correct spray tips, contact Gempler's Product Support. Thank you for watching. Let us know what you thought of this video or if you have suggestions for future video topics.